Stay behind me.
Gonna be honest here, I've never been a big XCOM fan. I played the original UFO Defense, but I skipped out on the reboot. I played XCOM 2, but never got all that deep into it. I think this game is the deepest I've gone into an XCOM game before, and I've got some mixed feelings on it. This is XCOM Chimera Squad.
"2 minutes out."
"Hey, Godmother. Is this like the old days? XCOM swooping in and taking it to the bad guys?"
"I wouldn't know. I spent most of the war training resistance networks."
"Like mine. And for your many long years of service."
"Watch it."
"XCOM attaches you to an untested squad and pushes it into the field before it's ready. How is this not like the old days?"
"I'm just happy to be here. I missed out during the war. Wish I could have pulled my weight."
"For which side, exactly?"
"I find that very hurtful."
"Sure thing, Advent."
Chimera Squad maintains the usual XCOM style, but makes it much lighter than before. Whereas in previous games the general tone was darker and more along serious lines, this game is more like a buddy cop film with aliens. Hey, wait. Everything is well lit, nothing is all that scary, the characters are always cracking jokes, possibly too many jokes.
"Contact!"
"Clear."
"Verge? What took you so long?"
"Had to unpack a breaching charge."
"Good man."
"Not exactly."
"You know what I mean."
"I always do."
"So creepy. Don't ever change."
And all in all, nothing is taken as seriously as it was in the previous games. Whether that's a good thing or a bad thing is really up to your personal taste, but for me it was a nice try at a change of pace for an XCOM game. Beyond that, the graphics kind of give off the fact that this is clearly a spin-off game. Nothing is quite to the level as previous installments, and just in general, you can more or less feel that lower budget this game had just by watching it for a little while.
"Welcome to City 31. During Advent's occupation, the city was a fortress supporting an active starport. 5 years after XCOM won the war, it's home to aliens, hybrids, and humans alike. There's new industry, self-government, and local agriculture to support the varied populations."
The story is much more scaled down here. This time you're not the valiant defenders of Earth, or organizing a global resistance to alien overlords. No, in Chimera Squad, you're a bunch of wise guys with guns, cracking a quip every time you crack a skull.
"Moving, quickly."
"Good move!"
Just be glad they didn't call it Homunculus Squad. Ugh. The basic plot is that the mayor of City 31, a city designed to show the world that aliens, hybrids, and humans can live alongside each other, is killed in a terrorist attack, and the Chimera Squad is brought in to try and figure out who was behind it, why, and to bring them to justice, all while ensuring the rest of the city is kept peaceful. At the beginning, you have to choose a faction to investigate for potentially being the ones behind the attack, or at least provided the terrorists with the armaments to do so and to take them out. Your operations will somewhat vary depending on which faction you choose, but the basic idea is the same. Investigate the faction, take them out, and gather intel to discover who killed the mayor. The story is serviceable, but the game's put way more focus on characters now. In previous XCOM games, your agents were just soldiers you could customize to your heart's content, but now each agent you recruit is an actual fully voiced character. This would be fine if the characters felt like they were more than just one-note tropes, but eh. Verge is a nerd, Cherub is simple and honest, and Axiom is big guy who punch good. For the most part, what you see is what you get.
"If a hostile force will cause imminent harm, you'll need to stop them by any means necessary. As always, subduing targets is preferable. We learn far more from captures than corpses."
For the most part, the gameplay is your standard XCOM affair. It's got the same turn-based tactics as before, but with a few tweaks. You have a home base like before, where you research and buy equipment, train your agents, etc. But instead of a world map, you have a map of the city where you can either use field teams to manipulate factors like unrest, which if left unchecked can lead to anarchy, or you can gather resources like money, intel, and Illyrium to spend before going on your actual combat missions. Speaking of which, each mission starts with a breach, where your squad members break into the area through one or multiple entrances and gives each one a preemptive shot at the enemies on the other side before the real fight starts. Breach entrances can also give characters who use them certain buffs like increased dodge, damage, accuracy, etc. Some go further than that by saying that only the first or last person to go through a breach entrance can get a certain buff or debuff or whatever it says. It's a pretty neat mechanic to consider, especially since you can only use certain entrances if you have certain items like breaching charges for walls or a universal keycard for locked doors. The game also allows you to knock enemies unconscious in combat instead of killing them like the monster you are. Knocking out an enemy is more difficult, but it will generally keep unrest low, and the more enemies you capture instead of kill will increase the chance of gaining intel which you can use to buy equipment from the side market or build and upgrade field teams. Beyond that, it's pretty much just scaled down gameplay from XCOM 2. Also, being able to mind control my agents from across the map is still bullshit. After having said all that, my feelings are still incredibly mixed about this game. On the one hand, the game is decently enjoyable to play casually, but on the other hand, it all just feels like a lesser XCOM 2 in a way. I suppose you can all make of that what you will. This has been The Ratman, and I will see you all later.